Assalamualaikum brothers and sisters. So in this video I will continue the second part of chapter 2 where we will cover the PN junction. But before that, I would like to define the drift and diffusion currents. So firstly, what is a current? A current is generated by the movement of charged particles. Okay? Electrons are negatively charged particles and holes are positively charged particles. Okay? So when we talk about movement of carriers, it means that we are talking about the charged electrons and holes. So the two basic processes which cause electrons and holes to move in a semiconductor are drift and diffusion. So the drift movement is caused by the existence of electric field. Okay? And diffusion is the flow of carriers caused by variations in the concentration. So let's look at one by one. So drift current is due to the existence of electric field. So for example, this is an N-type semiconductor. So let's say the electric field is applied in this direction, right? So this electron will face a force that is in the opposite direction of the electric field because of the electron's negative charge. So the electrons will move in the opposite direction and it will acquire a drift velocity VDN. And the movement of electrons will produce a current in the opposite direction. Okay, so now as for P-type semiconductor, if you apply the same direction of electric field here, it will produce a force on the holes in the same direction of the electric field because of the positive charge on the holes. So because of that, the holes will move in the same direction as the electric field. Okay, and it will acquire a drift velocity VDP. And therefore, the current will be in the same direction as the movement of holes. So again, current will move in the opposite direction of electrons, but it will move in the same direction as holes. Okay? Next is the diffusion current. So diffusion is the flow of particles or carriers from a region of high concentration to a region of low concentration. So the movement of the particles will then generate the diffusion current. This is the animation on how diffusion works. So now let's look at the PN junction. Before that, let's recall what is N-type. Again, N-type is a semiconductor where the majority carriers are electrons. As for P-type, the majority carriers are holes. Okay? So when we combine P-type and N-type together like this, okay, you can see that there will be electron diffusion. Electron diffuse because it sees the minority carriers here. Okay, so the electron will be tempted to diffuse to the P-type. Once the electrons reach P-type, it will recombine with the holes in your P-type. So once the electrons reaches P-type, it will create a negatively charged ions because the holes here gain electrons, right? But as the electrons diffuse, this area will become positively charged ions by losing electrons. So this diffusion process has created a charge separation area that produces an electric field in this direction, from positive to negative. So the electric field will create a force that will stop the diffusion of carriers, and the PN junction will reach thermal equilibrium condition. So what happens is that the electric field is in this direction, right? So the force on the holes will be the same direction, right? And the force on the electrons will be in the opposite direction. So the diffusion of holes is in this direction. So the holes will see this force and it will not be able to diffuse to the N-type. Similarly, the diffusion of electrons is from N to P. And because it sees this force in the opposite direction, the diffusion of electrons will stop as well once it reaches thermal equilibrium. And once it reaches that state, it will create a region known as the depletion region. Okay? So, the depletion region will create a barrier. And this barrier is known as the built-in potential barrier or built-in voltage. So, this is the formula to calculate VBI. So, VT is the thermal voltage given by the formula Boltzmann constant multiplied with T again in Kelvin over E. So Na is the acceptor concentration in the P region, Nd is the donor concentration in the N region. Okay, so you can see in the note here, right, that the thermal voltage is approximately 0.026 at 300K. So what if the temperature is not 300K? It means that you have to calculate thermal voltage using the formula here, KT over E. And when you have to do that, so you're going to use this value of Boltzmann's constant, multiply with the temperature T in Kelvin over the magnitude of the electron charge, 1.6 times 10 to the power of minus 19 coulomb. Right, so let's look at some examples. So the first one is a straightforward example. The temperature is in 300K, so the thermal voltage can be used straight away as 0.026 volt, and just use the calculator to calculate what is your VBI, right? In this question, even your intrinsic carrier concentration is given to you. So this is a very straightforward example. So this next example is a bit more challenging because the temperature is 400K. You are asked to calculate the built-in voltage. You are given the coefficient constant and the band gap energy for silicon at these two values. So what does that mean? So the first thing you need to do is calculate the thermal voltage because the temperature is 400K. So you can see that I use this value for the Boltzmann constant, the temperature over the magnitude of charge, and the answer is 0.0344 volt. But you need to calculate what is Ni because it is not given in the question. So that is the reason the coefficient constant and the band gap energy is given to you. So you calculate your Ni and I obtain this answer, and then only you can calculate what is VBI. Alright, so the answer is 0.922 volt. So you can see the importance of calculating Ni correctly because it is used in a number of formulas. So now let's look at reverse bias PN junction. So reverse bias occurs when you provide positive terminal to the N-type, okay, and the negative terminal to the P-type. So when you apply this voltage, let's call it VR here, okay, it will induce an applied electric field EA. So the direction of EA is the same direction as the electric field inside the depletion region. So because it is the same direction, the total electric field in the depletion region increases. Okay, so the E total equivalent to the electric field inside the depletion region plus the applied electric field. So of course, when you increase the electric field in the same direction, this force will increase and this force will increase as well. So you are just going to increase the force to hold the holes in your P region and to hold the electrons in the N region. Okay, so no current will flow through the PN junction except for a very small reverse bias current that can be neglected. So this reverse bias current is due to the minority carriers. For example, the electrons in your P type sees this force. So let's say there's an electron that becomes free in your P type. So it will see this force and it will be able to go through the depletion region and complete the circuit. But the current is very small that it can be neglected. Now, the depletion region is wider during reverse bias. Why? Because this is the reverse bias circuit, right? The negative terminal of the power supply will attract the holes from the P region. Okay? Because of the opposite attract. Similarly, the positive terminal of the power supply will attract the electrons, right? And so the electrons will be here at the edge as well. Okay? So the majority carriers are all move away from the junction, but still it does not allow the movement of carriers because it's just stuck here. Okay? So this in fact will increase the width of the depletion layer. So there is junction capacitance associated with depletion region. So when you apply reverse bias voltage, it will affect the junction capacitance of that depletion region. So this is the formula to calculate the junction capacitance. As you can see in the formula, it is dependent on the VBI and the reverse bias voltage here. Okay, so if you look at this example, you have to calculate the junction capacitance. You are given the temperature at 300K and you are given the Na, Nd and the default junction capacitance at 1.5 picofarad. And you apply a reverse bias voltage of 3.5 volt. Okay. So Na and Nd are given to you for you to calculate what is VBI. Okay, and you have obtained the value. The temperature is 300K, so it's just 0.026. Then you can use the values to calculate the junction capacitance. and you can see that the value is lower, 0.5928 picofarad. Why is it that it is lower? Because at thermal equilibrium state, the width of the depletion region is smaller, and then after that you apply VR and the width increases. This is because capacitance equivalent to epsilon A over D. So if you increase the D, the distance between the two plates, it will become lower. That's why the junction capacitance become lower when you apply the reverse bias voltage. So now let's consider the forward bias operation. For forward bias, your PN junction is connected as follows. The positive terminal connected to P-type and the negative terminal is connected to your N-type. Okay? And the direction of the applied electric field EA is opposite direction of the electric field in the space charge region or the depletion region. Because the positive terminal is like this, so electric field applied will be from positive to negative. So these are opposite direction. Okay, so because of that, the net result of the electric field, the E total, will be EA minus E. And it means that it will be in the direction following your EA. So if your E total is now in this direction, the force on electrons will be in the opposite direction. So you can see here, the electrons will be able to diffuse again because the force will be in this direction. Okay? So the electron is allowed to diffuse and the force on holes is following the direction of the electric field total, which means that the force on holes will be this direction and the holes will move towards the N region. The diffusion process continues as long as the VD is applied. As the electrons reach P region, it will see the positive terminal, and because of the opposite polarity, the electrons will be tempted to complete the circuit like this. Because the current flows in the opposite direction of electrons, so therefore the diode current moves in the opposite direction. So due to the diffusion of carriers, the width of the depletion region will reduce. Okay, because the electric field has been reduced as well. So it will reduce and the diffusion of carriers occurs. So this is the formula to calculate the diode current. So IS is the reverse bias saturation current. This is the current that I mentioned just now, that during reverse bias, there is a very small amount of reverse bias current that can be neglected. And as you can see, it is very small. And the thermal voltage, again, 0.026 volt at 300K room temperature. And N is the emission coefficient, which is normally set to 1. So for example, when you apply this formula for the first condition, when you apply a positive voltage, which means that you make it forward bias, and you key in the values here, you will get a positive current. However, when you apply a negative voltage here, which means that you are making the diode reverse bias, and you key in the values, you will get a negative current, which means that it is at the reverse bias region. And of course, it is negligible, a very small value of current. Right, let's look at the IV characteristic. So this is the IV characteristic, ID versus VD. And this is the diode symbol. And this triangle here means that this is the P-type and this is the N-type. So this is the forward bias condition. The positive is at the P-type and negative is at the N-type. From the diode current equation, you can see that the relationship between the diode current and the diode voltage is an exponential function, right? And the current is nearly zero in the reverse bias region. And this is just showing how the temperature affects the diode current. And you can see, as you increase the temperature, the turn-on voltage for the diode will decrease. Right? Turn-on voltage is the minimum voltage required for your diode to turn on. It is the minimum amount of energy required for your electrons to be able to diffuse through the depletion region and complete the circuit. We will cover this in the next part of your chapter 2. So I'll see you then. Bye. Assalamualaikum.